Day 6 of Advent, Micah chapter 2. Woe to those who plan iniquity, to those who plot evil on their beds, and at morning's light they carry it out, because it is in their power to do it. They covet fields and seize them, and houses and take them. They defraud people of their homes and rob them of their inheritance. Therefore, the Lord says, I am planning disaster against this people, from which you cannot save yourselves. You will no longer walk proudly, for it will be a time of calamity. In that day, people will ridicule you. They will taunt you with this mournful song. We are utterly ruined. My people's possession is divided up. He takes it from me. He assigns our fields to traitors. Therefore, you will have no one in the assembly of the Lord to divide the land by lot. In chapter 1, Micah has told us that the Lord is coming, and the Lord is coming in judgment, that it will be terrible and terrifying. Disastrous, destructive, devastating. And perhaps that sounds like a thing you don't look forward to. Who would look forward to? And yet here, as we read about the people who plan iniquity, who plot evil, who take fields and houses, defraud people, rob them of their inheritance. We look forward to a time of justice, don't we? It seems as though people get away with it. Not always and not completely, but more often than any of us would think fair. Or just, or right. And so when we say we look forward to the day of judgment, we're saying we look forward to the day of God's justice, when he will right those wrongs, when he will restore those inheritances, when he will grant people homes that have lost them. And when those who have plotted evil are brought to justice. Almighty God, give us grace that we may cast away the works of darkness and put upon us the armour of light, now in the time of this mortal life, in which thy Son Jesus Christ came to visit us in great humility, that in the last day when he shall come again in his glorious majesty to judge both the quick and the dead, we may rise to the life immortal through him who liveth and reigneth with thee, and the Holy Ghost, now and forever. Amen. Almighty God, as your kingdom dawns, Turn us from the darkness of sin to the light of holiness, that we may be ready to meet you in our Lord and Saviour, Jesus Christ.